Well, hello. Good evening, guys. As I told yesterday, I was planning for an online class, but you know how it is to work from home, right? Staying at home, you will hear a lot of noises. We cannot control the voices from outside, even from inside our home, right? I have a lot of people inside my home and I have to find a packed room where I can take class for you without any problems, all right? So the first thing I want to share is, of course, what you are seeing in the screen. This devastating disaster that is plaguing our world. What we can do for that, as our government and the doctor says, we have to stay at home, all right? So please, only few more days we have, as president gave us some deadline as a lockdown, all right? So let's stay in home until that and awaiting some more instruction from our PM, all right? So stay home, stay safe, all right? So let's go back to the class. Learning tools. As we have already discussed a lot in this topic, I just want to share again, because it's been 1 month since we had classes, right? And I guess you almost forgot a lot of things. So let's see whatever we have seen already. Okay, it will be like a revision. So at the end of the week, we'll have some online exams. All right. So as you know, what is a turning tool, right? We can turn something with it, right? Or what you are seeing in the image there is a wrench or a spanner and then a screwdriver, all right? So these two are commonly used to turn into us, okay? We'll see one by one. I just don't want to mess up your time, okay? Let's start with screwdriver. So you all know what is a screwdriver, right? As the name itself says, it is made for only one purpose, all right? Only one purpose. And what is that? Loosening or tightening the screw. So we cannot use this for any other things, right? For example, like switchboards, can we take this to test whether the current is coming through the switchboard or not? Or can we use this as a tester? No, that is a different category. All right. So this name, as it says, screwdriver. I think it's a lizard in my home. Don't mind it. So it can drive only the screws. All right. So you see the parts here. We have a handle, a shank, a blade, and tip. Okay, almost all screwdrivers will have the same parts. Some will have some modifications. We'll see about that. The major thing that you have to note down here is this tip area. Okay, so based on this tip design, we have the screw head design. Okay, this tip will join a specifically designed screw head. Okay, so that you have to note down, and the shank. Okay, so based on these, we have different classifications and we will see it one by one. All right. Now in this screwdriver, we can see a hex kind of bolt, right? Yeah, it's a hex bolt design near the end of the handle, right? So they call it as a ferrule. Can you guess what is the use of that? Yeah, I can read it here. So it can allow you to turn the screwdriver with a wrench to provide additional leverage in torquing or loosening screws. Suppose your hand power is not enough to torque or loosen the screw. So in that case, we can use a screwdriver like this. And in this region, we can fix a wrench, a open-end wrench or a box-end wrench, all right? And then we can give more power, okay? Your torque will be increased, am I right? Now, what it is made of, we should know about this, right? So generally it is made of steel. So we all know why steel is used here. And you can see the handle, it has two designs. One is made of wood and one is made of high impact plastic handles, okay? So the handle has two different designs. Now we will come to the other parts, that is the shank and blade size, okay? Then the blade shape. The shape of the blade is very critical here, as you can see from the image. So here we have different blade tip shape, right? Now this will fix exactly into a particular kind of screw head. We cannot use this slotted kind of screw, screwdriver tips anywhere else, right? Yeah, we cannot use anywhere else. And you see this design, hexagon design, we cannot use this screwdriver tip anywhere else. We can use only for a particular screw that is designed particularly to be used by a particular screwdriver. All right. So we will see about that one by one. Okay. So read this around. The blade is shaped or flattened to fit the recess in the head of the screws or bolts. Okay. If you see a bolt or screw head, if it has any recess design. So recess means nothing but a small depression in the head. Okay. Like a hole is cut out or some shapes kind of like these cut out. Okay. That's called a recess. Okay. So let's see one by one. So first thing, we'll start with a common screwdriver, that is a flat head or slotted screwdriver. So why it is called flat head is because it has a flat head design. All right. And here we have a slot in the head of the screw. So this tip of the blade can exactly fit in this region for unscrewing or torquing the screw. All right. So this point you have to remember. A slot screwdriver must fill at least 75% of the screw slots width. Okay, what it says? It says that this tip should fill at least 75% of the width in this area. All right. Otherwise, what will happen? Think. Otherwise, yeah, of course, if it is too small, the tip will break. If it's too big, the screw head may get damaged. Okay. So the FAR says at least 75% should be filling this slot with. All right. Next, now come to this variety, Phillips screwdriver. All right. So Phillips, as you can see, it has two different names, recess or cross point screwdriver. The why it is called cross point is because it has a cross pointed design in this region as well as the tip of the screwdriver. All right. So it is called recess because it is recessed here in this way. Okay. It has a long depression inside the head. So that's why it's called recess. Okay. And it's manufactured by Phillips. So generally it is commonly called as Phillips screwdriver. All right. Now, what are the important features you can note down is, of course, as I told you before, a screwdriver can be used for a particular kind of screw head for either loosening or tightening, right? So as you can see this design here, now this design has a cross shape point end, right? Now this can fix exactly in this crossed recess, right? So what are the main features of this screwdriver? Now this is one important feature, that is, it is designed to cam out when the driver reaches maximum torque. What is the meaning of that? The meaning is, so when you fix this screwdriver into this, then when you tighten it exactly at one particular moment, the screwdriver will automatically come out. Okay. For example, you are tightening the screw like this. How far you can rotate over hand? At one point, what will happen? The screwdriver will automatically come out. That is called camming out. Okay. So when it reaches the maximum torque, it will automatically comes out of the screw head. All right. So that is one necessary feature, right? But in some case, it is not a good feature. As why? Because I will say by comparing it with another screwdriver. All right. So wait for it. The main feature is, one is this, and you can see it is blunt on the end. Okay. This end is blunt. It has a cross shape. So remember that. And then if you see the cross, the center will be very large. Inside you can see it's a very large center, and here we have large area. Okay. Why I'm telling this is, there are other screwdrivers exactly designed like this, except there will be some distinctive features. Okay. We'll see. That is resist. The next one is resist. In that, we will see about reed and pins. All right. So before we have seen Phillips, right? Now this is a Phillips. Okay, as I told, we have a blunt end. Okay, but if you see the reed and pins, the only difference is It does not have a blunt cross. It has a pointed cross. Okay. If you see in this diagram, it is very clear. So this point will exactly go inside. But if you see in this one, it does not have a point. It has a blunt face. All right. So this blunt face will fix this screw head perfectly. And when you are trying to overtalk it, it will come out. Okay. That's a distinctive feature of a Phillips screwdriver. But Radian Prince is not like that. It has a sharp point. Alright, as you can see some angles here, they are written. So it is pointed around 45 degrees. These are standard things. And this one is around 30 degrees Phillips. Okay. The major difference is the Radian Prince is pointed. Okay. So this we have to remember. They also call it as a Frierson screwdriver. Alright. Now, positive. Now, this is also manufactured by Phillips. And I put this image in this so you can easily compare a Phillips with a positive. Alright. So as you can see, this is a Phillips screwdriver, right? So this will fit into the this blunt end, okay, of a Phillips screw head. But this is a positive screwdriver, and this is a positive screw head. Now, what is the difference you are seeing in these two screwdriver tips as well as the two screw heads? One thing you can see is on this area is called as float. All right. So near the float, we see some extra design, right? Yeah, the float has some extra designs in the sides of a positive. So what it will do when it goes inside this screw head, it will exactly lock this area. Okay, that's why they have given a big slots in these four sides. All right. So what it will do? So one thing it will do is it will not allow it to come out. Okay. When you are torquing it, as I told with Phillips, when you over torque it, automatically the screwdriver will cam out, right? It will come out automatically. But in case of a positive, it will not come out like that. All right. So it will get tightened and tightened. So why they have designed two different things like this? Suppose if you want to, if you're using this kind of screwdriver to remove a large number of screw heads. So what if you see some damage here, right? So when it is camming out automatically, it may get damages like this, right? So that is something we don't want, right? In screwdriver tips, especially in aviation field, it is very critical, right? We don't want to give little torque or too much torque to a particular kind of screw or bolt, right? So for that, they have designed these kind of positive designs. Okay. So this will perfectly give the right amount of torque. Of course, you have to keep in mind that you should not over torque it. Okay. Now that is a separate category. Okay. Don't over torque it. And this remaining, we have some two more types. That is a recessed or cross point screwdriver. In that one, we have seen around positive Frierson Radian Prince, Phillips, then before that we have seen flathead, right? So in that we have another thing called triving. If you see the recess even in the head of the screw, it has three slots only, right? One, two, three slots. But if you see in Radian Prince and positive or other Phillips, one, two, three, four slots are given in the cross, right? So that is a four slotted one. These are three slotted. Okay. So it is used in the specific areas as mentioned. So it is given as a triving because it has a triving design. All right. Yeah. And next, torque screwdriver. So this distinctive feature you can see here is it has a star shaped design, right? It is not exactly star. We can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 points are there. 6 peak points are there. As you can see here as well as here as well as here. Okay. So this can be specifically used only on a particular kind of screw heads. Okay. Where it has 6 pointed rails. Okay. Now you read this point. This is very important. The Torx type screwdriver should not be used for a Allen type screw. Okay, so you remember this. In next class, I will teach Allen type screw. So in that one, I will tell you exactly why Torx cannot be used. Allen will be like a, they don't have 6 points. It will be like a hex design. Okay, so you should not confuse this with that. Okay, if you see a slot with 6 points, we can use only a Torx screwdriver. Okay, we cannot use a Allen key scooter. Okay, because Allen keys will also have a, it will not have 6 points, but it will have a big hole kind of this. Okay, so we should not get confused with both the things. So far we have seen about the blade tip design, right? Flatted, read and prints, Phillips, then positive, then driving and talks. Okay, these are basic tip designs that you can see in an aviation maintenance field. All right, now we will see about the shank design. Now this heavy duty scooter, we'll see about heavy duty. All right, so heavy duty means, so as the name says, it is used for some highest torquing or loosening. Okay, wherever the high torque is required, you can use a heavy duty. Okay, so heavy duty comes with a big shank. Okay, it will come with a big shank, and the shank will be in square shape. So can you guess why it is in square shape? Yeah, we have already seen a design like that here. Okay, square design means similar to this ferrule design. Okay, the entire shank will be of this design. So what you can do, we can use a wrench in assisting the torque. All right, so that's why heavy duty screwdrivers are used for heavy duty. All right, so it has a square shank. Okay, so we can use a wrench. Stubby screwdrivers. So stubby is this image you can see, it's a stubby design. So stubby, the name itself says, it's a small. Okay, so like for example, like this, suppose where we can use this, suppose we have to confine the place like this. Okay, so you want to go inside this place and remove or tighten a screw. So what you can do, we cannot take a big screwdriver, right? So you have to take a stubby screwdriver, go inside and then unlock it. Okay, so that's where you can use a stubby design. All right, now the same kind of use as said in a stubby screwdriver, offset screwdriver can also be used for same work. Okay, wherever you cannot reach with a normal screwdriver, we can go with the offset design. The only big advantage in this is it can have different blade tip designs on both ends. Okay, that's the only advantage. Now there is another kind of shank design where the shank is actually reversible. Okay, you can see the shank with the blades, it has two kind of blade tips, right? So what you can do is you can remove it and you can reverse it and you can use another blade. Okay, so this will be helpful for you if you are walking away from your toolboxes. Okay, you don't need to take 2-3 tools in your hands. So one more thing is an interchangeable head screwdriver. The difference between these two is here that blade along with the shank, entire shank with the blade tip is removable as well as reversible, right? But here what they have done is they have kept the handles separately and they have kept the blade tips separately. All right, you can see three different handles here. One handle with a grip and ratchet mechanism, and this handle is having a square shank. You can see there is a flat head, so it is a square shank design. You can use wrenches in this, and this is another design where you can fix sockets and it also have ratchets. Okay, so there are different types of handles that you can fix with the different kinds of screwdriver tips. Okay, so you can see the symbols here. The symbols are very important. Okay, you can see this is a symbol for flat head and this is for read and prints. All right, why I said it's a read and prints, because it has a sharp point. Okay, and these are flat head designs. All right, you can see this is a, you can guess it, right? And this one you can easily guess it, right? Okay, driving, talks. All right, it has a hollow magnetized shaft. Now what is that hollow magnetized shaft? So that these shank of this tips can go inside this hollow shaft. Okay, hollow handle, so inside it will be having magnets, so this can be fitted very easily. It will not come down automatically. Okay, so this is also very helpful when you are walking away from your toolboxes. Okay, but the only thing you have to keep in mind is you don't want to miss any of these tips when you're walking in the area. Okay, because one tip goes out, it's not easy to find it. Okay, so when you're working with it, be very careful. All right, this one, of course, if you want to remove or tighten a lot of screws in your aircraft, then you want to save your time as well as save your energy, right? So in that case, you can go with a powered driven screwdrivers. Okay. So they have given it as a cordless. The meaning of cordless is it will not have the power cord. Okay. It comes with a battery that is chargeable. Okay. And it will have torque adjustments. Okay. So only these things you should know about it, because different company designs will have different additional features. So just keep in mind that a cordless means it does not have power cord. So it will come with a chargeable battery and it will have adjustments for torques. Okay. Now, the same thing what we have seen here is a powered one, right? So if your shop does not have a powered screwdrivers, now what we can do? Still you want to remove a lot of screws. So what you can do in that time? So you can have a Yankee ratchet type screwdriver. Okay, it is called automatic. I will show on a video for it so you will easily understand. See this. So just closely watch what he is doing. Yeah, you have to do only one action, not a turning action. You have to do push and pull action. Okay, we cannot do turning with this. We have to do push and pull. So just like this. So in that case, it will be very helpful for you if you don't have a cordless or powered screwdrivers. All right. So these are the different designs we're having based on shag designs. Okay. And based on the type of blade tips that is specifically designed for a specific screw head. All right. Now we'll see some safety precautions. Of course, we should know about it. Okay. So as I told, a screwdriver can be used only for driving the screws. Okay, we cannot use it for chiseling or prying. All right. So the another thing I told you before also, do not use a screwdriver to check an electrical circuit, since an electrical arc will burn the tip and make it useless. Okay, so that is a specific tester designed for using in electrical appliances. So we cannot use a screwdriver there. Okay. Now this is one thing that is very crucial. The last point: when using a screwdriver on a small part, always hold the part in the vise or rest it on the bench. For example, suppose it's a small part where you want to do some screwing or unscrewing. So we cannot hold it in our hand and then screwdriver in hand and then do like this. Okay. At one point, it may slip and damage your body. You may damage yourself, right? So in that case, the part should be held in a bench vise, tightened it, and then you have to unscrew or tighten it. All right. So don't hold it in hand and then screw it. Okay. So this is very easy, right? Yeah, screwdrivers, we all know what is a screwdriver, the different types. Okay, so just take your time. I will share the notes for this. Okay, so take your time and read all those things. The important things you have to know down is the different kind of blade designs, okay, shank designs, and where it is used and how it is used. All right, remember the symbols also. Okay, so next we'll have a small activity, okay, just to keep this class interesting. So you can see here, this is a flat head, okay? A flat head screwdriver is sitting here. And can you guess what it is telling to this? This is, I guess, we cannot guess from here. Yeah, I can guess. This is a read and print, right? You can see the edges are very sharp here, 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 here and all. Okay, so this is a read and print screw head, okay? What this flat head is telling to this read and print? Can you guess? Yeah, you can easily guess it, right? I think you need read and prints, my dear. Two doors to the left. Yeah. So this is an activity to freshen your mind. Okay. So you see the peculiar feature here is it has a flat head, right? So we can use it right here. The flat tip can go inside this head, right? Yeah. But why can't we use it there? Because the thickness of the blade, the length of the blade, everything is designed only for a particular kind of screw slot. Okay, and it has to fill 75% of the slot width. Am I right? So we cannot just take a simple flat head and use it here. The width of this blade tip may be higher or a little bit lesser. Okay, or it may not fit properly. Okay, in normal household appliances, we may do this, but in aviation, no, we cannot do that. Okay, a simple value in the torque that is a little bit higher or lower, it had led to a lot of accidents in aviation. Okay, I will share that in my next class. Okay, in a new topic. Okay, and this you can see. Your resume is impressive, Phillips, but I just don't think that they're good fit for us. Okay, this is the opposite of what we've seen before. Okay, this is a Phillips. Okay, you can see the end is not sharp, it is blunt, and this is a flathead screw. Okay, so how can we use it here? No, we cannot use it. Okay, so when you want to take this particular kind of screwdriver for a particular kind of job that has a particular kind of screw head, always see the tip design, the width of the tips, and then use accordingly. All right, now we will go into our next turning tool. Okay, let me check the time. Yeah, one thing we have seen is screwdrivers. Okay, that is designed for driving the screws. We also have bolt and nuts, right? So we need something to turn that also for either loosening it or torquing, tightening it. Okay, so there we can use our wrench. Some people call it as spanners, right? Yeah, what is the difference? Can you guess? It's nothing but America they will call it as a wrench, and British they will call it as a spanner. Okay, so there is not much big difference in that, so don't get confused. Okay, so what it is made of, what it should be made of, can you guess why we need a wrench? Okay, we can use our hand to remove or tighten the bolt and nut, right? We can do. No, our hand is not enough to give the enough power. Okay, so initial torquing till the end of the plate we can use our hand, of course, but for tightening to a particular value or for tightening perfectly tightly, we cannot depend on our hand. Okay, in that case we have to use a particular tool. That's why we need tools in aviation maintenance field. Okay, when we cannot use our hand, we can depend on the tools. Okay, so this wrench can be used for turning nuts or bolts. Okay, so it is made of this combination of steel, that is chrome and vanadium, because these combination will give you the high strength. Okay, it is very much hardened and it will not break very easily. Okay, and also this is plated with cadmium or hard chrome to protect them from the rust. Okay, so we are going to use this wrench is made of a particular metal, that is steel, and we are going to use it on another metal called bolt and nut. So we cannot just remove it and keep it aside, right? So when two metals are there, definitely there will be a chance for rust to form in a long period of time. Okay, so in that case we cannot depend on a plain steel. Okay, we have to coat it with something, that's cadmium or chrome. Okay, so it will prevent from rust. Now how it is measured, measurement of wrenches, can you give how it is measured? It is measured in inches, right? Inches, imperial standards. So you can see in fractions mostly, right? Metric standards also there. In inches, we can see mostly in fractions only, like 1/16, 2/16, 3/16, 4/16. Okay, like that. So up to 1-inch spanner, that 1 inch is 16/16. All right. So that is divided like that. So how this measurement is taken? So read the second point of the measurement. This measurement is also same as the hex head of the bolt from flat to flat. In a bolt, if you, the hex design means we have 6 flats. All right. So from one flat to one flat, this wrench will touch. Okay. Then we can use the wrench to turn perfectly. We cannot touch the corner of the flat and turn a screw. Generally, it will not fit in the corners, but generally we should not do that. Okay. If you are taking a big wrench to remove a small bolt or nut, in that case we cannot hold the wrench in the tip of the end of the flat to flat. Okay, we have to hold only from flat to flat. Okay, first you will see about open end. This we have seen commonly, right? It has an opening in each end that fits the bolts or a head. Let me see, I have less charge. And yeah, I'm back. So we were discussing about wrenches, right? Yeah, we'll start with the common wrench that is most commonly used. A open end wrench, right? You can see from the figure itself, it has this opening, right? It has opening on both sides. Some will have one side. Okay, the peculiar feature is that this opening and this opening both are parallel, and it has an angle of 15 degrees from this handle. Okay, can I guess what is the need for 15 degrees? I have written here. This angle allows you to turn a nut even when the space for the handle is severely restricted. For example, you have two closely packed area like this, and there is a nut in between. So we have to take a, if it does not have an angle, we cannot use it like this, right? But if it has already some angle, we can keep it there and we can do a small turn. Okay, so that's the need of this 15 degree. So this 15 degree will allow you to swing the handle 15 degree. Okay, so 15 degree swing is possible, means we can use this one. Yeah, you can see in this figure, the 15 degree is clearly mentioned. With respect to the axis of the handle, this is turned 15 degree. All right, we also have other combinations like 60 degrees, 30 degrees, even 90 degrees also there. Okay. Now, next one is a ring spanner. Some people will call it as a box end wrench. Okay. Why it is called box end is because the end, actually the part of a wrench is, we have a handle here, a shank or handle, and then we have ends. Okay. They call it as ends. So this is the open end because the end is open. But if you see this spanner or wrench, it has a box end. Okay. So why this is designed like this? Can you guess? I read the second part. It is completely surrounding the bolt or head. Okay, there is a mistake here. I will change it. It will completely surround the bolt or nut head. Okay, it's not knot, it's nut. Okay, we can either tighten or loosen a nut or bolt. Okay. So they are less likely to slip. So it will exactly sit over the nut, and it will very easy, it will be easily turning a nut. Okay. So that's why this box end design is made. Okay. And the only thing you have to observe here is the openings are 6 or 12 point opening. Okay. This is called opening or end. If you count the end of the flat here, this is one flat design. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 points are there. Okay. In the end of the flat, we count. This is one flat. Okay. Like that, we can see 6 flats or 6 ends of the flat. Okay. So this is a 6 end opening. Okay. And if you see here, sorry, there's a small error. Yeah. So we were seeing about the openings, right? So we have a 6 or 12 point opening. So we can count here, this is a 6 end opening and this is a 12 point opening. Huh? And this also has an angle of 15 degrees. Right? You can see this image also. Here it is really clearly written. So it is at an angle of 15 degrees. Okay? So how this will help you is, suppose there is a hole in this plate and there is a nut inside the hole. Okay, now we cannot take a normal open end wrench and then we can turn it, right? So we have to take a wrench, a box end wrench that has a 15 degree recess, 15 degree angle. Okay, then you can keep it there and turn. Okay, we cannot use a normal open end wrench. We have to depend on a box end wrench that has an angle of 15 degrees from the handle axis. Okay. It is not just turned away from the handle axis to 15 degree. It is just angled either upwards or downwards, we can say. Okay. So this design will help you for that. And next one we'll see about a combination wrench. Okay. As the name says, it has a combination of both open end as well as a box end. Okay. But can you guess why it is designed like that? For example, what is the major use of this box end wrench? I forgot to say that. Read the first point. It is used to break the torque on tight nuts. Okay, if the nut is too tight, we cannot depend on an open end wrench like this, right? The open end will not loosen it very easily. Okay, we need something that can grip the nut completely and then turn it. Okay, in that case, we can go for a box end wrench. Okay, so if you take a 12 point opening, it has 12 points, and these flats along with the 12 points can grip the nut very tightly and you can easily turn it. Okay, now that is a major advantage of a box end wrench. All right, now the problem is once you loosen the nut, how can we take it back outside? In that case, we cannot use a box end. Okay, when you turn it to one side, taking it and then turning it, it's not easy with a box end. So what you can do, if you have a combination wrench, shift to the side, use a open end, and then loosen and loosen and loosen. It is very easy to take it out and then loosen it completely further after loosening by a box end. Okay, now in that case, we can go with a combination wrench. Why? Because we cannot take two wrench in a hand and then do this operation. Okay, so this will simplify your operation further. Ratcheting open end wrench. Yeah, this has a specific design in the opening, as you can see in this region. So we can see a flat end, right? So this will touch one flat of a bolt. All right, but if you see the other side, it has some peculiar peaks, right? Peaks and recesses and peaks and recesses. So this will help you in gripping the nut. Okay, so when you are turning one side along the side of the flat, when you are turning, this grip area will grip the nut and it will tighten or loosen your nut. But when you go back without taking the wrench outside, you just turn it back, it will not grip. Okay, I will show a video, you will easily understand in that. Yep. So see this. Yeah. As you can clearly see, the grip area is actually this flat area is assisting. Grip area is actually turning the nut. Okay, and when you want to turn to other side, it is not gripping. This flat is not gripping on other side, right? But in case of a flat nut like this, you have to take it out. See, we take a flat nut, you have to take it out and then fix again. And then, but in the case of a ratcheting end, you can just turn one side and then turn on the other side also. So that's the big difference between these two. Okay. So this will ease your operation, but our opponent, we have to take it out and then fix it up. Okay. So that's a major difference. All right. So it does not have a ratcheting mechanism. So ratcheting means generally you can hear some sound, right? In a micrometer, the end of the micrometer, we have a ratchet lock. So we can turn it to only one side and you will hear some sound in there, right? So there are so many ratcheting mechanism in different kinds of tools. All will give a sound. But here, you don't have a ratcheting mechanism, right? It does not have a ratcheting mechanism. You just have a design. Okay. So this action it follows is ratcheting. Okay. It does not have a ratcheting mechanism to create that sound or something. The action it is doing is ratcheting. The ratcheting action means one side it is gripping, other side it is automatically loosening. All right. And so ratcheting we have in open end, in box end also we have a ratcheting. Okay. So as you can see, the outer end and the inner end are completely separated. Okay, the inner end that is going to grip a bolt or nut is separated from the outer design of your wrench. Okay, and between these two we have gear mechanism. So these gears are going to help. Okay, for this also I will show you a video. Yep. Yeah, you can see here. Thank you. So one side, these things will jump and then it will lock it. Okay. But when you try to turn on the other side, this will just lock it. Okay. These faces will just lock it. So only the handle will be turned. So this entire inner portion will be staying in the same place. So this is how we're getting the ratcheting action. So only one side it will get locked. So that's why we can turn the wrench. When you try to turn on the other side, it will get loosened. Okay. So that's how it, that's why it is having a gear mechanism. Now flare nut wrenches. Where you have seen these flare nuts? You have heard this term anywhere? I think you have heard this in module 6, right? So wherever you have ACA fluid lines, we cannot use a normal nuts there. Okay. If you want to join one pipeline with another pipeline, you need a flare nut. Okay. We have to apply certain specific process that is called flaring to one side of the end, and then other side you have to keep the nut and then join the pipe. Okay. So for turning the flare nut, we can use, you cannot use any other wrenches. Can you guess why? Because we have a lot of fluid lines. There will not be just a single fluid line in a single area. There will be a lot of fluid lines. Okay. So in that cases, we cannot swing your hand like this, right? It will disturb the other lines. So if you see this diagram here, it looks like a box end, right? But in the tip of the box end, there is a small slot cutter. Okay. So what you can do, suppose this is a pipe. This is a pipeline. Okay. You can slide this, flare nut wrench inside, and then you can come and lock in the nut and then turn with little degree swinging. You can see it is also angled to 15 degrees, right? For the, from the handle axis, it is also angled to 15 degrees in this direction. Okay. So we can just slide inside the pipeline, lock the nut and then turn with 15 degrees. Take it out, turn, take it out, turn. Okay. So this will give you only little swing. And it has very good grip design. Okay. So we cannot use a normal flathead or a box. Okay. So that I have to depend on a flare nut wrench. Now this comes handy, right? Adjustable wrenches. We can adjust the jaws. You see the jaw here? So it has a warm gear here. A warm gear is there. So one jaw is fixed with the handle, but the other jaw, it is connected to a warm gear, right? So this jaw, with the help of your finger, thumb finger, you can rotate this warm gear and this jaw can be moved inside and outside. Okay. So you can see the markings here. They are given 0, 1 by 4, 1 by 2, 3 by 4. So up to 3 by 4 inches, you can use this wrench, right? Now, one thing you have to notice here is which side we can turn this, because one side has an adjustable jaw, right? We cannot, we don't want to give too much pressure in the adjustable jaw. That will damage your gear as well as the jaw, right? So we have to see and understand very clearly which side this wrench has to be turned. Can you guess? Yeah. So you see, this one is a right one. Okay. This is a right way to turn. So we can swing in clockwise direction. Okay. So why? Because when you swing in clockwise direction, now this permanent jaw, the fixed jaw, so what it will do? It will assist the, it will actually turn the nut or bolt. All right. Now this jaw will get forced towards the wrench body. Okay. So if you try to turn in this side, what will happen? Suppose you are keeping the wrench in this way and turning clockwise, this kind of one. So this jaw is going to take a lot of pressure in turning. Okay. This jaw will not help you at all. So in that case, this jaw will easily break. All right. So you have to keep it like this. For to simply say, you read the last line given here, always turn an adjustable wrench towards the mobile. Okay. Whichever side you are holding it, always see the side and then turn along that side. So that jaw will get stuck with the body of the wrench and it will just assist you in turning. Okay. While this jaw will hold it perfectly. All right. So far we have seen some few wrenches, adjustable flat nut, ratcheting box, opening combination, ring spanners, Okay, don't confuse between a spanner and a wrench. Okay, different countries they call it like that. Okay, spanner is called in British countries, and wrenches are defined in Americans. Okay, so we have so many different types of other spanners. Also, these are standard ones. Okay, we have a specially designed spanner for some special purpose. Okay, for a particular kind of nuts, there is a separate spanners. Okay, so we will see that in next class. Okay. If you have any doubts, I'll give my mail ID in the description. Please mail me, note down the doubts and mail me. Okay, I will share the notes. This PPT also I will share with you. Okay, so read it, take your time. This is very short. I have taken a long time to explain it, but this is actually very short. We have only few screwdrivers and wrenches we have seen. Okay, so take your time, read it with the notes as well as the PPT. Okay, and then if you have any doubts, note it down and then mail to me. Okay, I will reply back. So we will see tomorrow further. Okay, until then, so goodbye.